Hello friends, my name is Ksenia and we are learning Russian. In previous lesson we started to learn cases of Russian nouns. If you didn't watch this lesson, please watch, because in that lesson I gave general review what cases of nouns we have in Russian language and what they mean. And now I will give you examples of nouns in different cases. Do you remember I made a course of 100 Russian verbs in present tense? And now one student recommend to make a course of 100 Russian nouns in one case of noun. Maybe it's a good idea, maybe not, I don't know, but at least we can try. We have 6 cases of nouns in Russian language. I can't make a course of 100 Russian nouns in all cases, because it will take all my life. But I may, at least it's possible, to make a course of 100 Russian nouns in one case. So now we have to choose what case to use for this course. So please watch previous lesson where I explain all 6 cases. Also watch today's lesson, because I will also give an example in all 6 cases. And let's choose. Please write in comment what case you think is the most useful, most important in your speech, and which case we will use for our course of 100 Russian nouns in dative case, for example, or in genitive case. But today, as an example, I will take a word river, река, and we'll take it in all 6 Russian cases to show you how we form these cases, how we change endings. So, river, река. So I say again that if you haven't watched the previous lesson, please watch, because I explain all cases. River. Nominative case, initial form, answers question who, questions who, what. River, река. River turns left. Sentence. River turns left. Who, what. River, river turns left. Река поворачивает налево, left, налево, налево. River turns left, turns, поворачивает. Река поворачивает налево. So you see, it's initial form, we don't change a word река. Река, река поворачивает налево, nominative case. Now, genitive case. A genitive case shows that something belongs to something. In English, we use this form with preposition of. So, genitive case. Bank of a river. Bank of a river. Берег реки. Now you see. Bank, берег. You see. Now word река changes its ending. Река, берег, реки. Берег, реки. Река, берег, реки. So a bank of a river. Берег, реки. Genitive case. Dative case. Dative case shows that something is given or addressed to something or somebody. A group of people was approaching a river. A group of people was approaching a river. So this group is addressed to a river. Группа людей приближалась к реке. К реке. Группа людей приближалась к реке. Group of people, группа людей. Группа людей, group of people. I was approaching, приближалась, приближалась. Группа людей приближалась к реке. Now you see also we change ending. Река, river, приближалась к реке, dative case. Река приближалась к реке. Группа людей приближалась к реке. Dative case. So we already have learned three cases. I remind you that we have to choose the most important for our speech, a case that we will learn in our long course. Now I will give you another three, and also another request. You may see that I uploaded previous lesson about 3 months ago. It's because I am very busy, I have a lot of work, I have and these lessons are free, I can only make them on my free time. So if you want to support this, my channel, my project, my lessons, please donate. It will allow me to spend more time for lessons. Otherwise we will learn our 100 nouns maybe 10 years, if I will make only one lesson 3 months. So please support if you may. All links is in the description of this video, and now we continue learning cases. Next case is an accusative case, shows that a noun is an object of an action. For example, I can see a river with my binoculars. So river is an object of an action. Action, see, we see it, it's an object. We see a river. I can see a river with my binoculars. Я вижу реку в бинокль. I can see or I see. Я вижу. I see, вижу. Я вижу реку в бинокль. В бинокль. Now you see ending U. Река, вижу реку. Я вижу реку в бинокль. Я вижу реку в бинокль. Река, вижу реку. We change ending. Next case is an instrumental case. Noun is a kind of an instrument which helps us to do something. Or also we use this case with several prepositions. For example, with preposition behind, за. We always use instrumental case. My house is behind the river. My house is behind the river. За, behind, we use instrumental case. Мой дом за рекой. My house, мой дом. Мой дом за рекой. Мой дом находится. Maybe we say my house is situated or is, находится. Мой дом находится за рекой. We may just skip a word, находится. Мой дом за рекой. So we understand that it means that the house is behind the river. Мой дом за рекой. За рекой. Behind the river. So, река за рекой. Behind the river. Река за рекой. We change ending. Мой дом находится за рекой. Мой дом находится за рекой. And the last case is a prepositional case. It's always used with preposition and shows a place or an object of a speech and thoughts about something or where. Answers question where or what about. A horse was standing in a river. A horse was standing in a river. Now shows place. Лошадь, a horse. Лошадь стояла в реке. In, в. Лошадь стояла в реке. В реке. Where? Где? В реке. Где? В реке. Лошадь стояла в реке. Лошадь стояла в реке. A horse was standing in the river. So now let's repeat our examples of all six cases. Река поворачивает налево, направо, left or right. Река поворачивает налево, направо. Берег реки, берег реки. Группа людей приближалась к реке, берег реки, группа людей приближалась к реке. Я вижу реку в бинокль. Я вижу реку в бинокль. Дом находится за рекой. Дом находится за рекой. Лошадь стояла в реке. Лошадь стояла в реке. Also, you remember, I have already told this, I've heard that when I or somebody says phrase in a with different voice, different intonation, it is easier to remember. So now I will say it very slowly, for example. Река поворачивала налево. Берег реки. Группа людей приближалась к реке. It's funny to say this way. Я вижу реку в бинокль. Because you hear different ways of saying, you remember it better. Дом находится за рекой. Лошадь стояла в реке. And now again, let's have a training as we usually do. I say English sentence, you say Russian. Sentences that we've learned today. Let's start. I say English. River turns left. You say Russian. I help. Река поворачивает налево. River turns left, река поворачивает налево. Bank of a river. Берег реки. A group of people is approaching a river. Группа людей приближается к реке. I can see a river with the binoculars. Я вижу реку в бинокль. My house is behind the river. Мой дом за рекой. A horse was standing in the river. Лошадь стояла в реке. Have you made any mistakes? Do you want to repeat it again? Okay, now also the same exercise, faster, and I hope you will make no mistakes. River turns left. Река поворачивала налево. Bank of a river. Берег реки. Group of people is approaching a river. Группа людей приближается к реке. I see a river with binoculars. Я вижу реку в бинокль. My house is behind a river. Мой дом за рекой, or мой дом находится за рекой. A horse was standing in a river. Лошадь стояла в реке. Молодец. This is all for today. So remember to choose a noun, case of noun that you find very important for using in everyday speech. Write a comment. If you haven't subscribed my channel yet, please do if you want. And let's learn Russian and make friends. Давайте учить русский и дружить. Пока.